Just like the operating system, Microsoft SQL Server must be kept up to date with the latest updates and patches to remediate security vulnerabilities, address performance issues, and resolve known bugs. The updates are typically delivered as cumulative update packages, which are roll-up bundles containing all previously released critical and hotfixes. For mission-critical servers, always schedule SQL Server updates, or any updates for that matter, during a planned maintenance window and inform users of possible downtime. Log into the SQL Server with a local or domain account that has local administrative rights. First, ensure your operating system is fully updated and patched. If winget is installed, use it to update installed applications where possible. Ensure the SQL Server service account, if it is not local system, has write permissions to the destination backup folder. Connect to the SQL Server instance using SQL Server Management Studio, SSMS. If SQL Server is configured for Windows authentication, ensure your user account has sysadmin rights. Verify the current SQL Server version. Right-click the server, Properties, General page, and note the version. Expand databases, right-click each database, select Tasks, Backup, and create a full database backup. Alternatively, we can use SQL command to check SQL version, list databases, and perform backups. Use an administrative terminal, command prompt, or PowerShell. Use SQL command to check the current SQL Server version. List all user databases. Backup the desired databases to the destination backup folder. Visit Microsoft's official latest updates and version history for SQL Server webpage and scroll to the latest updates available for currently supported versions of SQL Server section. Find the latest cumulative update for your installed SQL Server version. If you're running a version earlier than SQL Server 2019, consider upgrading to a supported version to continue receiving cumulative updates and general distribution releases. At the knowledge base article for the cumulative update, scroll down to the How to Obtain or Download section. Expand the dropdown next to the Microsoft Update Catalog. Right-click the download link to open a Microsoft Update Catalog page in a new tab or window. At the File Information section, expand the file hash information and note the SHA-256 hash. On the Microsoft Update Catalog page, download the update. In a terminal, navigate to the directory where the update was downloaded. Use the get-filehash commandlet to get the SHA-256 hash and ensure the hash matches what you recorded from the knowledge base article. Run get-filehash again, specifying SHA-1 as the algorithm to ensure it matches the embedded hash in the update's file name. An interactive update installation is pretty straightforward. Open the folder where the update is located. You must close SSMS or any other SQL Server management tools before beginning the update. Double-click and acknowledge the UAC dialog. Of course, you agree and accept the license terms. The update will upgrade the SQL Server binaries and shared features. It will not affect the user databases. Once the file in use check is complete, you are ready to update. During the update process, the updater will automatically stop the SQL Server and related services. Following a successful update, SQL Server services will start. Verify the update using SQL command. We'll apply the update in silent mode remotely via a privileged administrative workstation using a remote PS session. On the admin workstation, log in as a user who has administrative rights on the server running SQL Server. Open an administrative terminal or PowerShell session. Since the update may take some time, we want to ensure we don't interrupt the process with an inadvertent session disconnect. Use the new-p PSSession commandlet to invoke a persistent PSSession. Use the get-PSSession commandlet to view the connection. The state should read open. Use enter-PSSession to connect to the persistent session. Ensure that in the remote session, you have administrative rights. The command should return true. Change directory to the folder containing the downloaded update. Optionally, re-verify the SHA-1 hash using get-filehash to ensure it matches the value embedded in the file name. Run the update using the silent installation parameters. Be patient, as this will take a while. This is why we used new-pssession to create a persistent connection that will continue to run in the event the inner-pssession is accidentally closed. When the update appears to be complete, verify it was plotted successfully with SQL command. Exit the session. Now use the remove-pssession commandlet to close the session. Check again with get-pssession and notice the session is no longer listed. If you have SSH Server enabled on the SQL Server as a means of remote management, you can use that protocol to connect. Log into a domain-joined Linux workstation. Establish an SSH connection to the SQL Server. By default, the SSH connection will place you in a Windows Command Prompt session. Type PowerShell to enter PowerShell. Again, verify that within the remote SSH session, you have administrative rights. Use SQL command to check the current SQL Server version, list user databases, and perform database backups. Change directory to the folder containing the downloaded update. Run the update using the silent installation parameters. When the update completes, verify it was plotted successfully with SQL command. Type exit twice to exit PowerShell and to terminate the SSH session. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative. If you have feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please share them in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share this video with others. Thank you for watching. I truly appreciate it.